evening, everybody. Welcome to your last fantastic Monday, turning point of November. Hang on just a second. I'll be right back. Sorry about that. I hate when I get talking and can't talk. But, Monday, November 28th, 2022, and episode 4, wait a minute, 2, 3, 4, episode 406, we're going to be talking about, okay, I said all that, episode 406, we're going to be learning about big and small. Beginning with Psalm 8, verses 3 and 4, our recommended reading is Psalm 111, the whole Psalm 111. Our turning point is from Isaac Watts, and there is a footnote at the end of the first section, right here, right where my finger's at. We'll get to that when we get to that in a minute. So, but if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Remember, smashing the like button will help the video reach other people. And, remember to 4 likes only for every video until further notice. And if this is the first time you're hearing that, go watch the morning video, the first video for today, and it'll have an explanation of what my like challenge is all about. I usually put at least once a day. Usually the morning ones. If I forget to do it in the morning one, then it's in the afternoon. So, but it's usually in the morning that I explain my 4 likes only mandate. So, but until further notice, it's 4 likes only. If there's if the video already has 4 likes, go to another one and then put a like on it and get it to 4. So, But how was your Monday today? How did it go? Let me know. Subscribe if you're new. Turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me reach that 30 subscriber mark by January 1st, 2023. And if we hit that 30 mark before then, which is about 4.5 weeks to go, then we'll be going to 50, and I'll be extending the goal to hit the 50 mark. And then I would like to be at 100 by my birthday, April the 18th. So, I know that's a hefty light goal, but if I can get a bunch of subscriber things like I did a few weeks back, if I can get a bunch of those, I'd be getting close to, I'd be more close to 50 by then. If I can get at least 5 or 6 more like that. Because I got about 5 or 6 subscribers within a 5 to 9 day period. I was like, boom, boom, boom. Like, whoa. And I haven't gotten no more since. So, but I would like to have more. I would like to have as much as I could get. I'm trying to get to those goals, so. But big and small, if you do that for me, I will greatly, greatly appreciate you. So, for big and small, Psalm 8, verses 3 and 4. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him? That sounds like a poem. That verse actually sounds like, you read it like that, it sounds like a poem. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him? You see how it sounds? So pastor and author Tim Keller, K-E-L-L-E-R, has written, "To be loved but not known, To be loved and not known is comforting but superficial. To be known and not loved is our greatest fear. But to be fully known and truly loved is, well, a lot like being loved by God. It is what we need more than anything. It liberates us from pretense, humbles us out of our self-righteousness, and fortifies us for any difficulty life can throw at us. And that comes from Timothy Keller, The Meaning of Marriage. The book Meaning of Marriage. New York, New York, Penguin Books Publishing, 2011. So that comes from his book called The Meaning of Marriage. And that footnote will be at the in the description box below. That will be in the description box below so you can look it up for yourself. But before we go any further, let's read the recommended reading. Turn in your Bibles to Psalm chapter 111. Yep. Come on. Let's do it that way. I've got a marker in there at got 10 verses. So it says, "Praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly of the upright in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, studied by all who have pleasure in them. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endures forever." Excuse me. "He has made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious, full of compassion. He has given food to those who fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He has declared to his people the power of his works, and giving them the heritage of the nations. The works of his hands are verity and justice, and all his precepts are sure. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and uprightness. He has sent redemption to his people. He has commanded his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all those who do his commandments. His praise endures forever." Amen. So the psalmist David was overwhelmed that someone as big as God could know and care for someone as small as a human being. Psalm 8, 3 through 9. So we read 3 and 4. David was also greatly comforted by how intimately God knew him on a personal level. Wherever David went, God was with him and knew him. God, whose thoughts cannot be counted, knew every one of David's thoughts. As you can read that in Psalm 139. David was both known and loved. All who belong to God in Christ. So don't be afraid of God's knowledge of you. Read that in Job 7, 17 to 19. Let his power and goodness be a reason for humility and gratitude in your life. Talking about gratitude again. We just finished Thanksgiving week. Now we're talking about more about gratitude. So Isaac Watts says, "The heavens declare thy glory, Lord. In every star thy wisdom shines." So that's all I have for you today. I got one more there. Okay, never mind. But coming up tomorrow, in your last terrific Tuesday of the month, we're going to be talking about the next The Series video and number 128, which 127 was on Saturday night as a bonus video. It got posted real late, but it's still there. I apologize for that. We're going to be talking about episode 916. Yeah. 9:16, part one, and we're gonna be discussing the living word, the word of life, beginning with the verse, with the beginning line that I learned in Word of Life Ministries when I was down at the Word of Life Bible Institute there in Hudson, holding forth the Word of Life. I'll let you know that tomorrow in tomorrow's video. But that's from Henry M. Morris. Part two, after one tomorrow, we're going to be discussing about a hot meal from Katara Patton, K-A-T-A-R-A, Patton, P-A-T-T-O-N, derived from Matthew 25, 34 through 40. And then tomorrow night's episode 407, for your terrific Tuesday Turning Point Devo, for Tuesday, November 29th, 2022, we're going to be learning about a wall of protection, beginning with Proverbs 25, 28. Our recommended reading is Proverbs 16, 32. Our turning point is from Winston Churchill. And then we finished up Romans today. So we start on 1 Corinthians 1 through 4 tomorrow. I didn't really realize how many chapters Romans had. But it has 16 chapters. So we start on 1 Corinthians 1 through 4 tomorrow. So stay tuned for those. I'll get to those later tonight, but you'll see those at hopefully after 7, 1, 1 p.m., and 7 p.m. So, but with that said, I love you, appreciate you, thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do, 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell, come back tomorrow for those three great lessons to learn, what God wants us to learn in those three tomorrow, and we'll see what we got. So, but with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later, or see you tomorrow. Goodbye. Enjoy the rest. Have a great rest of your Monday evening and come back tomorrow for another terrific Tuesday and the last one of November. So, we'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.